welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. Today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is chapter number 10, Geometry. In this chapter, we are going to learn some basic geometrical figures and their properties. If you see in the textbook, there are the questions which are based on the construction of geometrical figures also. But we are not going to learn that construction now. We are going to learn only the properties, name of the figures and their properties. Okay, and the question based on that. So see, we have been learning geometry since first standard. In first standard, we have learned some basic shapes in the geometry like this. We have seen some figures. The figure with three sides and three angles. It is called, what is this name of this figure? Triangle, right? Also, we have seen triangle. Also, we have seen the closed figure made up of closed curve. Figure made up of closed curve. It is called circle. Okay? Then, the figure made up of four sides and four angles. Four sides and four angles. It is called, and all four angles are of 90 degree. Opposite sides are equal. It is called rectangle, right? Rectangle. The figure with all four sides equal and all four angles 90 degree. All four angles are of 90 degree. All four sides equal. This small line which is on every side, all four sides, that indicates that this side, this side, this side and this side, all four sides are same, of same length. Okay? So, the figure with all four sides equal and all four angles of 90 degree. This figure is called square. Okay, so these basic four figures we have learned in first standard. Further, in second standard, we have learned 3D shapes, okay, like a sphere, cylinder, cube, cuboid, cone, pyramid, etc. After that, in third standard, we have learned the components of the figure, means what figures are made up of. The smallest part of figure is this. What is this? This is called point. This is called point. Okay? This is the smallest component of the figure. Smallest part of the figure. Where, like, see, these here are three points. It is called now vertices. One point is called vertex also. Okay? So, when three vertices are joined together, they form triangle. Similarly, see, this is point, then what is this? This is called line. This is called line. L-I-N-E. We can give name also. And this is line AB. Line AB. Okay? Then what is this? One side end point, one side arrow. It is called ray. It is called ray. Okay? And we can give name also. Suppose ray PQ. Line AB. Ray PQ. Okay? And see this. This is called line segment. This is called line segment. I tell you properties of all these three XY. Okay, so it's line segment XY. We can give name to all the figures in the geometry. Now see, line, ray and line segment. What is difference in this? If you see the line, it has arrow. It has arrows from both the side. What is meaning of this arrows? You know, line has no definite length. It can be extended for uncertain distance. Okay, uncertain distance. So we cannot measure the length of line. We cannot say the line is 5 centimeter long, line is 5 kilometer long. No, line has no definite length. Okay, the meaning of this arrow that is we can extend, we can increase from both the ends, both the sides for uncertain distance, indefinite distance. Okay, this is the property of line. Ray, now you can tell me one side arrow is there, one side point is there. What is the meaning of this point? This is starting point. From this side we cannot extend, cannot increase, but as there is arrow on one side, the meaning of this arrow is the ray can be extended from one side for uncertain distance. So can you tell me the length of the ray? Can the length of ray be told or measured? No, because from one side it can be extended for uncertain distance. So again, measure of ray also cannot be determined. Okay, then there is line segment. Now line segment, line means this line, segment means one part of line. Line segment means it is one part of line. This is suppose line, then we can from here to here, this part is taken here, it becomes line segment. So the part of line that is line segment has end point from both the sides. So we can take, we can determine, we can measure the length of the line segment. Understood? We can measure the length of line segment, whereas length of line and length of ray cannot be measured, cannot be determined. Okay, so only the length of line segment can be told. Understood? So these four are the basics of the basic part of the geometrical shapes. See, in this way, this is called curve. It is not straight. Line is, see, line is straight. This is not line. This is called curve. C-U-R-V-E. It can be this way also. This way, okay? And this way. It can be closed also. See, circle is made up of curve. Circle is made up of curve. C-U-R-V-E. Curve. Okay? Circle is made up of this curve. Understood? Again, now see, here the triangle is made up of three sides and three corners. The corners means this. They are called corners. No, corners are called vertices. One corner, vertex. V-R-T-E-X. And three corners means vertices, many vertices. Okay? So triangle has three sides and three angles. Angles means inside the see, when two sides meet each other here, they form their angle inside. Okay, similarly here also, if you see this rectangle, four sides are there, this side and this side, where it is meeting here, they form angle here. And which type of angle it is? Angle of right angle. Okay, now again, right angle means what? Right angle means angles are also having measure. When two rays come together, this is one ray and another ray starting from same point, it comes here. Okay, so they form here angle. This is called angle. This is one ray, this is another ray. When they meet the two rays, what is meaning of angle? When the two rays come out from same starting point. Two rays come out from same starting point. They form angle at their starting point. Okay? This is called angle. We can give name also to the angle. Suppose here this ray, here there is OA, and this ray, name of this ray is OB. So the angle which they have made here, the name of that angle is angle. This is the symbol of angle. Angle AOB. AOB. और BOA सेम, एंगल AOB और एंगल BOA सेम. ओके अंडरस्टूड एंगल मींस व्हाट? ओके सो वी हैव लर्न दिस बेसिक फोर शेप्स, द पार्ट्स ऑफ द ज्योमेट्रिकल फिगर्स, कर्व एंड अबाउट एंगल. राइट एंगल मींस व्हाट? एंगल्स आर आल्सो गिवन मेजर्स. एंगल्स वी कैन मेजर द एंगल. डू यू नो इन आवर कंपास बॉक्स वी हैव प्रोट्रैक्टर, प्रोट्रैक्टर इन दिस वे. ओके सो ऑन दैट यूजिंग दैट प्रोट्रैक्टर वी कैन मेजर द एंगल. नाउ इफ द मेजर ऑफ एंगल इज 90 डिग्री, एग्जैक्टली 90 डिग्री मींस इट विल बी इन दिस शेप. इट्स मोस्ट ऑफ अवर बिल्डिंग्स, अवर हाउसेस आर मेड अप ऑफ इन दिस एंगल, 90 डिग्री एंगल. इट इज कॉल्ड राइट एंगल. इट इज कॉल्ड RIGHT, right angle. Angle having measure 90 degree, it is called right angle. Okay? Now see this square has 4 right angles. Rectangle has 4 right angles. All 4 angles of the rectangles are of 90 degree, that is right angle. Whereas all 4 angles of square are also of 90 degree, that is of right angle. Okay? So this is called right angle, angle having measure 90 degree. Understood? So this is about some basic information of geometry. Now let's solve the practice exercise 17, which is based on the geometry. Now in this, again I repeat, we are not going to learn the construction, because in MCQ type questions construction cannot be asked. We are going to solve only the questions which are based on the properties of the of these geometrical shapes. Okay. See the first question. Recognize the geometrical figures 1 to 15 given below and write their geometrical names. We have to identify. Open your page number 190, exercise 17. Observe the figure and write the name of it. First one is obviously triangle. Second is, see, observe. It has arrow at one side and only A point at one side. It is called ray. Correct? Third, what is that? Close curve, circle. Fourth one, see, all four sides are same. They have denoted by same symbol. That means all four sides are same. Also, all four angles are of right angle. If the angle is right angle, then it is denoted by this symbol in this way. Then it shows that this angle or measure of this angle is 90 degree, right angle. Okay, so which is such figure having all four angles of 90 degree and all four sides equal? Square. Which? Square. Okay. Why I am taking this fast? Because we have already learned this. Fifth one is end points from both sides. It is called line segment. Correct? Sixth one. All four angles are of 90 degree, but opposite sides are angle. Opposite sides are same. All four sides are not same. Opposite sides are same. It is called rectangle, right? The next, seven, what is that? Two rays, and where they are forming angle, this symbol is given. Which kind of angle it is? It is called right angle. It is called right angle. Okay, eight to one. हाँ नाउ सी दिस एट वन फिगर. Now with the figures which we have seen, this figure is out of that. All four sides are not same, or opposite sides are not same, not an angle is given. But see, it has four sides. It has four sides. So the figure which has four sides, the figure which has four sides, I'm not saying four equal sides. The figure, any figure having four sides, it is called quadrilateral. What? Quadrilateral. See, these names are new for you. So say, be habitual with the name. Recite these names again and again. Quadrilateral, right angle. Okay. Quadri. Why it is called quadrilateral? The figure with four sides. It is called quadrilateral because quadri. Quadri means four. Lateral means sides. Okay. So figure with four sides, quadri means four. Okay. So figure with four sides, it is called quadrilateral. Understood? Next. Ninth one is again. Sorry, eighth one here, quadrilateral. Okay. The ninth one. What is that? Yes, ray. Tenth one. Three sides, obviously triangle. Eleventh one, rectangle, correct? Or quadrilateral also we can write. Rectangle is rectangle, square. These are types of quadrilateral. These are some types of special quadrilaterals. We can say quadrilaterals. Okay? They also have four sides, but they are special quadrilaterals. 12. Now see 12th one figure. Okay. How many sides this figure has? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It has 6 sides. So the figure with 6 sides is called hexagon. Hexagon. Hexagon is 6. Okay? Hexagon. The figure with 6 sides is called hexagon. See, figure with 3 sides. Figure with 3 sides is called triangle. Figure with 4 sides is called quadrilateral. Figure with 5 sides is called pentagon. 6 sides hexagon. 7 sides heptagon. 8 sides octagon. Figure with 9 sides nonagon. Figure with 10 sides decagon. Okay, these are some names of the figure. Okay, then 13th one, 12th one, hexagon. Then 13, it is what? Triangle. It is triangle, but see, they have given this way. All three sides are same. Means which kind of triangle it is? It is equilateral triangle. Equi means equal. Lateral means sides again. Equilateral triangle. Means the triangle having all three sides equal, it is called equilateral triangle. Okay? Equilateral. Equi means equal. Lateral means sides. Equal sides. Triangle having equal sides. It is called equilateral. 14. What is that? 14th one? Rectangular. Okay? And 15th one? It is line or ray or line segment? Line segment. End point from both the sides. Understood? These are the names of the figure given here. Pause this video and write this in your notebook. Or you can write in the textbook also and below that figures. Okay?
See next.
16th one question don't solve because it is construction. Means we have to construct angle and bisector. We have not learned that. We are not going to learn. Afterwards we will learn. 17. See question number 17. There is one figure. In this way, P, M, M and L. This is ray PM, ray MN, ray ML. Okay, three rays are evolved from one starting point. So obviously they form their angle at the starting point. Now the question is, how many angles are there in the adjoining figure? Write their names. Means how many angles are there? We have seen angle means what? When two rays comes out from one common starting point, they form their angle. So this is suppose O, A and this is B. Then here this is angle. O, angle A, O, B or angle B, O, A means only one angle. Okay. Likewise here how many angles are there? See, this is question of intelligence. Okay. Let's check how many angles are there. Now see. Angle L, M, N. This is one angle. Angle L, M, N. Okay. Angle L, M, N. Then this is one angle. Angle this. P, M, L. Correct? Angle P, M, L. Only two angles? One more angle is there. Which is that? These. These and these. Okay? Means this angle. Angle P, M, M. Angle P, M, N. So, how many angles are there? There are three angles. Understood? Three angles are there, not two. This small two and this big one. Understood? Three angles are there. The next question number 18. They have given one triangle. And in that, it is given that triangle is again divided. Okay? A, B, C, D, E. So the question is, how many triangles are there in the adjoining figure? Write their names. Means in this total how many triangles are there? Okay. So what you will do, you will start counting, right? This 1, 2, 3. There is one shortcut trick. What is that? See here three parts are there now. You name 1, 2, 3. Okay, three parts of triangle are there. So give name 1, 2 and 3 and number of triangles is equal to, just add this number 1 plus 2 plus 3, total 6, finish. So there are 6 triangles in this. Now we have tried names also. Which are 6 triangles? Let's see. Let's see 6 triangles. Triangle ABC. See this small triangle, okay? A triangle ABC. Then triangle ACD. Then triangle ADE. 3 over. Again 3 over. 3 we want. See this. Triangle ABD. ABD, this triangle made up of these two small triangles. Triangle ABD. Then next triangle ACE. This. Correct? ACE. And one, last one. Can you guess? Triangle. This big one triangle. ABE. Are there 6 triangles? Yes. So how to count the triangles? If the such type of triangle is given, then we have to write 1, 2, 3 numbers in each part and just add them. You will get total number of triangles. Understood? Next. 19. Question number 19. Write this. You can pause the video and write this. They have given in the adjoining figure, how many rectangles are there? How many rectangles are there? Though no right angle sign are shown, all angles are right angle. Means what? You know, rectangle has all angles right angle. So they have given instruction that here though right angle sign is not shown, but all angles are right angle. That means they are rectangle. Okay. So we have to count how many rectangles are there. It's very easy. See now, what I am going to do. See, this is big rectangle. It is in this way. Horizontally, it is divided into two parts. See, I will show you. This way it is divided into two parts. Okay. And in this way it is divided into three parts. So what I am going to do, I will take first upper part. Means this part, okay? And I give name to them. Now each part is right angle, right? This is right. So this is rectangle. This is rectangle. This is rectangle. So I have put numbers in each rectangle. So now in these, how many total rectangles we will get? 1 plus 2 plus 3. 6 rectangles, correct? See which way? This 1, 2, 3. Then a rectangle made up from 1 plus 2 means this is 1 and this 1, 2 and this big rectangle. Okay, total 6 rectangle we got in upper part. Now I take small downside part, separate I am taking up. Again 1, 2, 3. How many rectangles are we getting here? 1 plus 2 plus 3. That is 6 rectangles again. Okay, again I will get here 6 rectangles. Okay. 6 and 6, 12. Again. Now, what I will do, I will take this big one whole. But I will take now vertically. In this way. Sorry, horizontally. Okay, not horizontally. In this way, vertically. Means what? It was divided here, no? That will be cancelled, and this both the these and these will be considered as a one. Okay, so this again here 1, 2, 3. So we will get here 1 plus 2 plus 3, total 6. Got understood what I have done? This small means this upper. This means this downside part, and this means whole. This way, okay. So in each part, here 6 rectangles we are getting, here 6 rectangles we are getting, and in a whole we are getting 6 rectangles. So total, how many rectangles we are getting? 6 plus 6 plus 6, 18 rectangles. Again, I'll show you, then we'll come to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay. Then this 7, 8, and this one whole 9. Then again down 10, this 11, and one whole 12. Okay, then this way horizontally 13, 14, 15, correct, and then 16, and from here to here 17, and then this big one 18. Okay. Total 18 rectangles are there. Understood? See, 28 it is construction, we will not do that. 21 also construction. directly we will take 24.
This part they are darkening.
Okay, how many different arcs are there in the adjoining figure? How many different separate arcs are there in the adjoining figure? So, arc means what? Curve. Arc means curve. So, such how many different curves are there? So, due to these small lines on this, the whole curve is divided. Okay, so from here to here it is for one curve, from here to here two, from here to here it is third curve. And from here to here it is fourth curve. So this whole circle is divided into four curves, that is four arcs. How many arcs are there? Four arcs. Arcs means curve, which we have seen. 25th, in the adjoining figure, three segments are drawn. Okay, this is circle they have. And here P, L, M and N, and it is they have joined PN, LM and M. Okay, and what they have asked, in the adjacent figure, adjacent means this, in the adjacent figure, three segments are drawn by joining two of the points named in the figure. Three segments. Segment means line segment. This is your 1, 2 and 3. Three line segments are drawn in this circle by joining the points on the circle. How many more segments can be drawn to join the points names? Write down their names. So again, how many line segments we can draw here in this figure? Again, how many more line segments can be constructed, can be drawn? Means how many points can be drawn? Okay, name them. Now see, four points are there, P, P, L, M, N. So as they have joined P, N, L, N, M, N, which we can join again more? We can join P, L. Okay, P, L we can join. So line segment, P, L. Again, which? We can join PM, correct? Line segment, PM. Further, we can join LN also. Line segment, LN. Can we join any more? No, three only. So, how many? Three more line segments. Or segments simply. Can be joined. Understood? Next. See next, 22nd, 26th also it is construction. If the exam will be conducted after when school will get started, then we will learn that constructions, okay? Otherwise no, we will learn in regular maths. Now see 27th, question number 27. There is one figure. Pay attention carefully. Okay. So, how many right angles are in the figure aside? Means in this figure which is given beside. How many right angles are there? How many right angles are there? Only we have count right angles, no? Yes, right angles. Okay. How many right angles are there? Now, we have seen that right angles means nothing but the angles having measurement 90 degree, and it is denoted by this sign. Okay, so now see this angle, see it is right angle, correct? 1 plus, now this angle is right angle, that means this angle is also right angle, this plus this angle, see, right angle, plus this angle is right angle, that means this side also right angle only, this, okay, plus this is right angle, this is right angle, this is right angle, means this, it is shown by this sign, that means it is right angle. How many? 5, plus, now see, this here, it is not shown, but it becomes right angle, because if three angles are, see, this is rectangle, and it's 1, 2, 3, three angles are right angle, that means fourth one also automatically becomes right angle, okay? So this total, how many right angles are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 6 right angles, okay, that's 6 right angles. Observe that figure very carefully, you will also come to know. So see in here, we have seen till question number 27, question number 28, 29 and 30, try to solve by yourself. If you have doubt, I will clear your doubt, okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.